not for the purposes of reproduction. Most Asari believe it weakens our species. Asari daughters inherit racial traits from the father species. If both parents are Asari, then nothing has been gained, or so conventional wisdom would hold. I am what is sometimes called a pureblood. Though no Asari would ever be cruel enough to say the word to my face, it is a great insult among my people. It is possible Benezia's partner was embarrassed by their union. She may have been too ashamed to publicly acknowledge me as her offspring.
Maybe she wanted to meet you but couldn't. Something could have happened to her. Maybe she passed away.
You might be right. I hope you are. But I have no way to know for sure. Benezia never spoke of her partner. Whatever happened, it caused her too much pain to dwell on it. She raised me by herself, though that is not uncommon. Many Asari raise their children alone, particularly if the father species is short-lived. Often the partner will pass on long before the child reaches maturity.
You Asari live for 1,000 years. What happens when your partner dies?
Few sapient species live as long as my kind. We have learned to take a philosophical approach to our unions. We do not focus on the inevitable loss of our partners. Instead, we enjoy the time we spend with them. And even after they're gone, a part of them lives on in us. The union is a connection that transcends both time and space.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
I always make time for my officers.
Off the record, I think there's something wrong here. This Saren is looking for records on some kind of galactic extinction, but we can't get backup from the Council? Sorry, Commander. There's writing on the wall here, but someone isn't reading it.
The Council doesn't want to believe anything's wrong. I'd call it human nature, but...
I hear you. It just seems like a group that's been around as long as the Council should see this coming. It's funny, we finally get out here, and the final frontier was already settled. And the residents don't even seem impressed by the view. Or the dangers.
Well, well. You're a romantic. Did you sign on for the dream, Alenko? Secure a man's future in space?
Yeah, I read a lot of those books when I was a kid, where the hero goes to space to prove himself worthy of a woman he loves, or, you know, for justice. Maybe I was a romantic in the beginning, but I thought about it after brain camp. Biotic acclimation and temperance training. I'm not looking for the dream. I just want to do some good. See what's out here. Sorry if I got too informal. Protocol wasn't a big focus back in Bot.
Tell me about it.
Biotic acclimation and temperance didn't last past the airlock. To the kids they hauled in, it was brain camp. Sorry, Haldane is unkind. We were encouraged to commit to an evaluation of our abilities so an understanding of biotics could be compiled. There are worse results of accidental exposure to Element Zero in the womb. Beats the brain tumors some kids grew up with.
Seems like you beat the odds. How many didn't make it?
Out of 100, maybe 60 have no effect. 30 suffer adverse effects, little things like brain cancer. The other 10 show enough ability to augment with implants. Not always permanent, though. Not like the cancer. Next thing you know, you're out on Jump Zero. And how's a kid supposed to deal with that? A station at the edge of human space.
Jump Zero is Gagarin Station, right? What's it like?
Yeah, that's the official name. Biggest and farthest facility we had for decades. Right on the termination shock, the outer edge of the solar system. It's where they did all the Goose Chase FTL research before we caught on to using mass effect fields. It was a sterile research platform when I was there.
There were other kids in the same boat, right? At least you weren't alone out there.
That's true. We did have a little circle that'd get together every night before lights out. We didn't have much to do, though. It was a research platform then, and Kinetics kept Jump Zero off the extranet to prevent leaks.
And you must have had plenty of time to get to know each other.
Yeah. We'd sit around and bowl every night after dinner, play cards or network games. There was this girl named Rana, who had a little circle grow up around her. She was from Turkey. Her family was very rich. But she was smart and charming as hell. Beautiful. But not stuck up about it. Like you, I guess. Ma'am.
Sounds like she was special to you.
She was. Maybe she felt the same. But things never felt together. Training, you know.
You know of any intentional exposures for certain?
No one knows. Doesn't mean they didn't happen. As big as the exposures were, it was hard to track down accidentals. It was different then. No one knew the potential, so there wasn't a lot of regulation. Anything Kinetics did was gold. I'm not saying they intentionally detonated drives over our outposts, but in retrospect, they were damn quick on the scene.
Jump Zero's a long way from home. What was it like?
The grand gateway to humanity looks a lot better in the vids. Anyway, this was supposed to be a casual debrief, not a bull session about stuff that happened years ago.
We have to depend on each other in combat. I like knowing what kind of man I have at my back.
I understand, ma'am. I won't let you down. You, make a habit of getting this personal with everyone?
No, I don't.
I'd like that. Anything you need, Commander?
We'll talk later.
I'd like that.
Why did you want to be a CSEC officer in the first place?
That's a good question. There were several...
Like what?
Probably the same as most officers. I wanted to fight injustice, wanted to help people. I guess my father had something to do with it, too. He was CSEC, one of the best. I grew up hearing about his accomplishments or seeing his picture on the vids after a big arrest. He's taking my resignation pretty hard.
That's tough. But you'd think he'd be impressed you're going after Saren.
My father's a CSEC man to the bone. Do things right or don't do them at all, he says. He thinks I'm being too rash, too impatient. He's worried I'll become just like Saren. He actually taught me how to becoming a Spectre when I was younger, for the same reasons.
You were asked to be a Spectre?
Well, I was targeted as a possible Spectre candidate. Me and about 1,000 other Turian military recruits. I could have received special training, but my father didn't like it.
He despises the Spectres. He hates the idea of someone having unlimited power with no accountability. He wouldn't like you, Commander. No offense.
I suppose I can understand his concern.
You can. But Saren's not gonna play by our rules, CSEC's rules. If you want to nail Saren, you need to send someone who isn't restricted by policies and procedures.
You're a quick learner, Garrus. We'll beat him at his own game. It's the only way to stop someone like him.
I'm right behind you, Commander.
Commander, good to see you.
Commander?
What's your opinion of the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. Tassoni's story about her and her mom not talking. They're family, right?
I think she's being straight with us. Or at least I don't think she lies very often.
Yeah, she's probably really bad at it. Hey, want me to ask her about her sex life? Might be illuminating.
I don't think she's used to teasing, good-natured or otherwise.
No fun, Commander. Too bad those ruins got destroyed. I mean, they lasted thousands of years. That's impressive.
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
Sure. I was hoping to get a minute of your time. Off.
Is this duty-related, Chief?
No, ma'am. Well, maybe. I know things are different aboard the Normandy, but, I'm concerned about the aliens. Vakarian and Rex. With all due respect, Commander, should they have full access to the
ship? Don't mince words, Chief. What's your concern?
This is the most advanced ship in the Alliance Navy. I don't think we should give them free rein to poke around the vital systems. Engines, sensors, weapons.
I'm not gonna lock them in sleeper pods for the whole trip, Williams.
I'd be more comfortable if they didn't have access to engineering and the CIC. We, humanity, I mean, have to learn to rely on ourselves.
Standing up for ourselves doesn't mean standing alone.
I don't think we should turn down allies. I just think we shouldn't bet everything on them staying allies. As noble as the council members seem now, if their backs are against the wall, they'll abandon us.
I don't see that as inevitable.
Look, if you're fighting a bear, and the only way for you to survive is to sic your dog on it and run, you'll do it. As much as you love your dog, it isn't human. It's not racism, not really. Members of their species will always be more important to them than humans are.
You sound like one of those Terra Firma party pamphlets, Chief.
Terra Firma is a pack of jackals. The founders had ideals. These days they just play off xenophobia and bigotry. I hope my reasons are more rational. My father, grandfather, great-grandmother, they all picked up a rifle and swore the oath of service. I guess we just tend to think of Earth's interests as our own.
All right, I can see where your concerns are coming from, Williams. But this is a multilateral mission. You're gonna have to work with aliens, like it or not.
It won't be a problem, Commander. You say jump, I say how high. You tell me to kiss a Turian, I'll ask which cheek.
I'm glad there won't be a problem.
Anything else you need, Commander?
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
I'm sorry, Commander. I need to get my duty squared away. I wouldn't mind ma'am? Commander? I'm sorry. I wouldn't mind talking more late, ma'am?
So, we've got Saren on the run.
It won't be long now. Saren's good, but I'm better.
Good. He's rotten. To the core. I could tell as soon as I met him.
Why didn't you tell me this sooner?
I would have if I thought it was important.
I think I'd like to hear about it just the same.
This was a while ago. A bunch of mercs were bragging about a job out near the edges of the Terminus systems. They said it paid well and the boss was never around to ride them. They said he was looking for more men, too. So I checked it out.
I didn't know Saren was openly recruiting mercs.
It wasn't that open, and he only showed his face once. We'd been raiding ships in the area for months when we took out this massive cargo freighter. Our biggest haul yet. I was on board checking bodies for valuables, looking for some extra credits. That's when I saw him.
What did Saren want with the ship?
I don't know what he wanted. He was just moving through the ship, watching. A couple of the mercs called him by name, but he never spoke to them. Never spoke to anyone. I had a really bad feeling about him, so I got the hell out. Didn't even wait to get paid.
What kind of cargo was the freighter carrying? What was Saren after?
I don't know. All I saw on that ship was food and medical supplies. There were some basic weapons, but nothing big. If there was anything of value on that ship, I didn't see it. That's why I didn't mention it sooner.
Whose ship was it?
There was a Volus trading vessel. Big one. Lots of guards. But they were no match for us.
That's the only time you saw him?
Yeah. Didn't even know who he was. Still wouldn't if I hadn't joined up with you. But my instincts were right. Every other merc on that mission turned up dead within a week. Every damn one.
So long, Rex.
Shepard. Shepard?
I found this armor. Does it belong to you?
Let me see. Damn. This is it. Hard to believe my ancestors wore this piece of crap. But at least it's back where it belongs. Thanks, Shepard. I might be starting to like you after all.
You getting soft on me, Rex?
Huh. Just because I like you doesn't mean I wouldn't kill you. Shepard?
Rex?
Commander, how are you?
Looking for supplies?
Not right now.
No problems. Keep checking back.
Something I can do for you, Commander.
Carry on,
Alex. Aye, aye, Commander.
Shepard, I need to talk to you. It's important.
Is something wrong?
You know the data you took from those Geth control nodes? The information you uploaded to Alliance Control? I want a copy of it.
You want to bring this data back to the Migrant Fleet?
Those files have information that could be vital to our efforts to understand the Geth. It could be the key to helping us reclaim our homeworld.
If I give you this data, your pilgrimage is over. You'll go back to your own people.
Not right away. I'll stay with you as long as it takes to stop Seren. But my people need this.
You think you can use this information to destroy your enemy?
Not right away. We will need to study it. It could take years, but it will give us new insight into how the Geth have changed and evolved over the past...
Go ahead. Make a copy.
My people, I owe you a great debt, one I can never repay. The only thing I can offer in return is what you already have. My solemn promise to stay with you until Seren and his Geth armies are defeated.
I never wanted anything more.
Thank you, Shepard. Oh, hello, Shepard.
Are you okay?
I don't know. Your ship is amazing, and your crew's been really great to me. Especially your chief engineer. But I just sort of feel out of place. The Normandy runs so smooth, it feels like we're not even moving. And the engines are so quiet. How do you sleep at night?
The silence wakes you up?
Back on the flotilla, the last thing you want to hear is silence. It means an engine's died or an air filter shut down. I guess you don't have to worry about that here. But old habits die hard. But it's more than just the silence. This ship feels so empty. It's like half the crew is missing. Back home, I couldn't wait to go on my pilgrimage. I couldn't wait to get away from the crowds. Now that I'm out here, I kind of miss them.
Sometimes we don't appreciate what we have till it's gone.
That's true. I'm starting to wonder if that's what the pilgrimage is really about. It's given me a whole new perspective on my people and our culture. You know, there's always a few who go on their pilgrimages and never return. I always assumed something bad happened to them, but maybe they just wanted a different life.
You do plan to return to the Migrant Fleet, right?
I could never abandon my people, Shepard. I will go back eventually, but we have to stop Seren first. Otherwise, I might not have a home to go back to.
I should go.
See you later. Hey, Shepard. You need something?
I should go.
See you later.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you got.
You bet, Commander. Looking for supplies? You bet, Commander.
Thank you.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you
bet, Commander.
Thank you.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you
bet, Commander.
Thank you. Yes, Commander?
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, ma'am.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Commander, Miss Algelani's story on you just aired. She shouldn't have ambushed you like that. But you handled it pretty well.
She wasn't the most sympathetic audience.
You handled yourself pretty well, Commander. She came across like a raving idiot. Just wanted to let you know what the response was back home. I won't keep you any longer. Fifth Fleet out.
Message for you, Commander. Just came in over a secure channel.
Shepard, this is Admiral Kahoku. I found out who set that trap for my men. The ones killed by the Thresher Moor. Damn, I hope you get this message. It was a group called Cerberus. An Alliance Black Ops organization. Top secret, highest level security clearance. They vanished a few months ago. Dropped right off the grid. Nobody knew where they went or what they were up to. They've gone completely rogue, Shepard. They're conducting illegal genetic experiments, trying to create some kind of super soldier. I don't have any proof, but I found the coordinates for one of their research worlds. I'm uploading them with this message. They're completely out of control. Somebody needs to stop them. I've done my part. Now it's up to you. This is probably the last you'll hear from me. Cerberus is after me now. I need to disappear before they find me.
Thank you. Thank you. Shepard.
Thank you.
have waiting for us at the next base.
Patching you up.
Thank you.
We owe Kahoku that much.
Oh, Goddess. It's Admiral Kahoku.
Cerberus must have tracked him down.
Thank you.
Just lead the way.
Thank you.
Ready.
Transmission coming in, Commander. I think you're gonna want to hear this one.
Greetings, Commander Shepard. I represent a party interested in obtaining information on Cerberus activities.
Who are you, and who do you represent?
Who I am is inconsequential. Suffice to say, I am an agent for the Shadow Broker. You see, Admiral Kahoku contacted my employer looking for information on the location of any Cerberus facilities. We provided that information on the promise that he would turn over copies of all files gathered from the Cerberus systems to us.
Did you have anything to do with Admiral Kahoku ending up dead?
We had no reason to harm him. He was going to provide us with information about Cerberus. Information that is now in your possession.
You must have some connection to Cerberus. How else could you tell Kahoku where to find them?
Information is our business, Commander. Through our contacts, we were able to determine that the Cerberus group was active in the Voyager cluster. Unfortunately, that was all we were able to find out. That is why we are so interested in acquiring copies of the files from you.
These are classified Alliance files. I am not handing them over to you.
Be reasonable, Commander. Cerberus was operating outside Alliance jurisdiction. You don't owe them any loyalty. The Alliance is just going to file this information away in some archive. But no secret stays hidden forever. Eventually, someone somewhere will deliver it into our hands. Might as well be you. Transmit the files to us and you will be well compensated.
What are you gonna do with this information?
Information is a commodity. It can be bought, sold, or traded. Why my employer desires this information is not my concern. I am only the buyer.
My loyalty is to the Alliance, not the Shadow Broker.
That is unfortunate, Commander. My employer will remember this the next time you need something from us.
Thank you. Thank you.